The TP-Link Deco X60 is TP-Link's Wi-Fi 6 mesh router system that competes with the Nest Wi-Fi, Eero, and Orbi. It's been 6 months since we got ours from TP-Link, and in this video, I'm going to take you through what it's been like to use over the long term and if I think it's worth it to pick up a Deco X60 system. First up, let's talk about the design of these routers and the setup process. Overall, I like the design of the routers. They look nice and are a bit tall compared to something like the Eero, but are similar in size and shape to the Nest Wi-Fi. The Wi-Fi points have an additional Ethernet port, which is a big plus over competing products like the Nest Wi-Fi point. The only thing I don't like about the device's design are the power bricks. They're long and rectangular, and if you're plugging them into a surge protector power strip that's already pretty full, it's going to be a challenge to get it to fit. Now, one of the most critical parts of any Wi-Fi experience, and where a lot of people actually run into issues with their Wi-Fi router, is the setup experience. Thankfully, with the Deco, the setup experience is dead simple. It maybe took me like 5 minutes to set this thing up. You just download the TP-Link Deco app on your phone from the Play Store or App Store, plug in the first point as your main router, connect it to your modem, and then follow the on-screen instructions. To add a new point to the Wi-Fi network, all you have to do is plug it in and it'll automatically be added to your system. Once set up, I'd recommend spending some additional time going through the Deco app because there are likely a few settings you'll want to tweak and learn more about. One of the things I always look for when setting up a new router is the ability to turn on and off that LED status light. That's because my routers typically sit behind my television, and yes, I do know that is not the best place to put a Wi-Fi router. The Deco does have a way to turn off the LED status light, and you can do that by going into the Deco app, which isn't the best designed app in my opinion, and you'll see why as we go through some of the features. You go into the app, click on More, Advanced, and then LED, then turn the selector on or off. You don't have the ability to turn on or off the status indicator on individual points, or the ability to just dim the indicator lights. Alright, back to the main page of the app. One thing that keeps tripping me up in this app is how to actually see the different points in the system. To do this, you need to tap the internet globe symbol, which there isn't any indication from the design that it can be tapped, so you just kind of have to know, which isn't the most intuitive design. This is the area where you can see all of the Decos in your system and see which devices are connecting to which Deco point. One interesting thing that TP-Link built into the app is the next tab over called Smart Actions for Smart Home Devices. It's not something I've ever used, and I'm unsure that people are going to choose their Wi-Fi router app for their home automation versus something like the Amazon Assistant app, Google Home app, or Apple Home app. So I'm not really sure that this setting deserves its own tab within the Deco app, but you know, I gotta give it to them. It's an interesting idea nonetheless. Parental controls are table stakes for routers nowadays and are built into the Deco at no additional cost. These settings are found in the Home Care tab. You can filter content by creating profiles and then selecting specific filters for that profile and then block specific categories of content as well as apps or websites. You also have the ability to set time controls, so you can limit the time each profile has on Wi-Fi for weekends and weekdays, and there's also a bedtime feature that you can set up for a profile to make sure your kids aren't staying up too late using Wi-Fi. The last step in creating a profile is attaching specific devices to it so the router knows which devices to turn Wi-Fi on or off for. Once you have a profile set up, the app makes it really easy to instantly pause or resume Wi-Fi for a profile. QoS is another setting you may see in the Home Care section of the app, and that feature allows you to prioritize specific kinds of traffic on the network as well as specific devices. So, for example, if you're uploading a video to YouTube, you might want to prioritize the computer uploading. You can set devices to always be a priority device or only prioritize devices for a specific duration. In the More Settings section of the app, you'll find advanced features like being able to turn on and off the 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz networks you get from the router, which can be useful if you need to force some smart devices onto one or the other. Here you can also test internet speed, which is only testing the speed from the internet to the main router, not to your end device, which I do think TP-Link should have included. Network optimization is a feature that was added during our 6 months of testing, and when you select it, it gives absolutely no explanation whatsoever for what it's doing. People on the TP-Link forums had the same reaction, and according to someone who reached out to the development team of the Deco, network optimization, quote, lets Deco intelligently scan and for a clearer channel to switch your devices to, guaranteeing optimal Wi-Fi performance. It would have been helpful if they had included that description in the app itself, because without it, it comes across as more of a gimmicky feature than an actual serious one. One other really important feature that you'll see in this section is managers. You can invite others in your household to help you manage the network, and this is really useful if you're setting up the router system for a grandparent or a parent. It allows you to monitor the network remotely and help them troubleshoot issues. All right, so those were some of the core features. Now let's talk about performance. This Deco Mesh Router system is a Wi-Fi 6 system. Why is Wi-Fi 6 important? Well, Wi-Fi 6 does offer increased speeds over the previous generation of Wi-Fi, where I've actually seen the biggest impact with Wi-Fi 6 router setups, including the Deco, is when you have multiple devices, like a large number of them, connected to your network simultaneously. I typically have anywhere from 40 to 50 devices on the network at any given time. With that amount of devices, I have noticed an increase in stability of overall network performance with my Wi-Fi 6 setup. Also, this system has great range. One reason I always go for a mesh Wi-Fi system is I need enough signal to be able to get out to my Model 3 across the street in its garage for software updates, and this system is able to push out enough signal for my 3 to pick up, which is great. All right, now let's talk about issues and downsides. The biggest issue I've had with this system is overall network performance. Initially, my Google Nest speakers would drop Wi-Fi connection at random, and the upload speed on my iMac dropped to 3 megabits per second, where before, while on my Nest Wi-Fi, I was getting close to 10. I tried changing some of the settings on my router, and I looked to the TP-Link forums to try to see if anyone else was running into the same issue I was, and some people were, but they didn't seem to have any resolutions at the time, so eventually I just ended up getting two Eero routers because it was the pandemic and I needed Wi-Fi that worked and worked really reliably. Now, over the past few months, I've switched back and forth between the Deco and my Eero system, and I'm happy to say that subsequent firmware updates seem to have fixed my initial issues and why I now recommend this system. The Deco system is definitely competitive with other systems out there, but with the added advantage of Wi-Fi 6 and the advanced controls, this system brings a lot of value. The only thing I think is still a slight disadvantage with the Deco is its app. There are just some UI and UX decisions that make it a bit more difficult to use than it should be. Now, I wouldn't say that's a reason not to go for this router system, but something to keep in mind as you compare it to competing routers. Alright, well, I hope you found this review helpful and informative, and if you did and liked it, make sure you hit that thumbs up button below and subscribe to the channel to see more 6 months later reviews like this one on tech and home products. For 6 months later, I'm Josh Tedder. Thanks for watching.